All right, I do believe we are live here, coming to you today live at about 11:30, 11:35 here from Upsala, Minnesota. It's Heritage Days weekend here, and the parade is just about to start. The rain has stopped finally, yay! So we are ready to go. So thank you for joining us. If you're joining us on Facebook, if you're watching this later, you'll be watching it on YouTube, and you'll have a higher resolution version of this video right there. So let's get into the parade today. So coming down the street, we've got the color guard. They're getting up here by the hardware store there.
That one's mine.
Quinn, you took mine.
Get the cameras all situated. There are still some, for those of you watching from out of the area, we still have some pop-up showers that are happening to the west. So we might get dripped on. We do have the umbrellas, and we are ready to go. The parade was supposed to start at 10:30 today, but we had about a quarter inch of rain, at least south Gray Eagle, we had a quarter inch this morning. So that we are now here, about an hour late, but we have a parade. And as you can see from the road, it is drying up. Heritage Days weekend here in Upsala. They started out with some music in the park last night. And now today there is a car show that's happening over at the mill behind me here, the Central Soda site. Then we have the Borgstrom House is open today. They're doing some things down there. Then the park is where it's all happening, or a lot of the fun stuff with the kids. Some kids games down there and food and water fight and a variety of different things going on today. And then this evening there's fireworks and some entertainment. So it's a busy weekend here. This is a 5K run, I believe, this morning. I haven't heard if it did go or not, but you know, what's a little rain to keep runners? They won't slow them down. If it did, they weren't dedicated quite enough, if you know what I'm saying. So here comes the color guard leading our parade today. Color guard here rolling on through, bringing the colors through our parade today. Next, coming onto the screen is Morrison County Sheriff. Sheriff Larson there. There he is, coming onto the live stream. Next, we've got the Upsala Fire and Rescue coming through. Additional vehicles here from the Upsala Fire and Rescue rolling on through here today. watching the live broadcast on Facebook of the Uppsala Heritage Days Parade. Delayed, but not skipped this year. Rain slowed it down, but they are up and running.
Snatch you in the pail.
Holding Ford Fire Department next. And behind the Holding Ford, we've got the next red one is the Bolas Fire Department. We saw a puff of smoke, and then you hear the bang way down. Got a little bit of a gap in the parade route.
There's more vehicles.
So once the parade is done, a lot of the water trucks. There we go. Yeah, you can see them. On the corner of the screen, you probably can see those shooting. But there's a lot of activities going on out at the grounds after the parade today. And of course, the rain looks like it's going to be kind of wrapping up here for the morning, and hopefully we'll have a dry afternoon. You guys can come down. Now you can't quite see it. It may be on the very right of the screen. You can see the little cloud of smoke and then hear the bang. There's a noticeable delay between the two. Hey Donnie, thanks for joining from Albany today. A couple of the Fort Ripley vehicles coming through next. Gonna fire up the big gun on the front, or yeah. Yeah, that's not as far as they can shoot. We got to see those in Swanville. When they crank that up, they could shoot a lot farther than that. It's only about 70 feet roughly. There's the big one. Coming to you live from Uppsala, Camp Ripley's got a couple of their water trucks that are coming onto the screen very slowly, but they're coming onto the screen now. Got, of course, that remote control water cannon there on the very top. You can kind of see it going back and forth.
When it stops, it's
no, you're not going to run in front of it. You're going to be wet and cold. Goodness gracious.
Okay.
It's not quite warm enough. Swanville is a little warmer, so the kids were getting in front of that. That cannon is waterfall. Camp Ripley, fire protection vehicles right there. It looks like it's losing water pretty well there. Oh, is it a single driver doing it all? Yeah, I could slow them down. Drive and throw candy in. There we go. That was the long one. 150 school band. Kids rolling on through here. County chapter of the Minnesota Citizens in Concern for Life moving on through next. Of course, this is a Wild West theme this year. And you can tell that it's a Wild West theme because of the attired folks coming through. Look at that. Everyone's going to want to get a suit just like that for prom. Nice. The Albany Home Bakery. Posing for pictures. Oh boy. Thank you for joining us. We are in Upsala here today. Lions, Upsala Lions rolling on through next. Yeah, they definitely have some. That's the big cloud of dust there, or the big cloud of smoke. Edwin Jones, Jeffrey Barth rolling on through next with the Nelson Insurance also. Let's try to follow the rowdy cowboys. It's a Wild West theme going on here. And this would be part of it. Hey there, guys. There's the crew. Going past what is now the new Upsala Jail, by the way. I don't know if you guys can see that on the cameras. Right there, over there. The city of Upsala has added a jail right on Main Street. And of course, some of those rowdies in that group will probably end up there later today. Lone Eagle Auto Club coming through with the vehicles. Whip demonstration he's doing behind us here. Getting into some of the older cars coming through next. You are watching live here in Upsala for the Heritage Days parade. Managed to get quite a few cars here. Kind of wondering how that was going to work with the weather this morning, but it looks like they are here, looking sharp as always. I was wondering if they were going to be coming a little bit later and just hitting the car show. But it looks like we've had a nice representation in the parade. Streets clean from candy. More vehicles here from the Lone Eagle Auto Club out of Little Falls. They hit a lot of the parades around the area in the summertime. is starting to peak out just a little bit here in Uppsala. You're watching us live on Facebook. There will be a YouTube version of this video that will be a little bit higher resolution. So if there's something you want to see a little more detail, that would be the one that we'll go check out a little bit later. The YouTube one may not get up though yet today, depending upon how much footage I get today. 1937 Chev there, Chevy coming, rolling on through. Big nice T-bird right there coming through. Next, we've got Mike Schabel there from Gray Eagle. He's part of the Heritage Days, the Central Minnesota Heritage Club out of Bertram. They are having their annual event coming up here August 24th, 25th. This happens just northwest of Bertram, about a mile and a quarter, maybe a mile and a half out of town. You guys can go check that out. It is a great weekend to go and check out what you're going to see on the next truck. Not only old vehicles, old tractors, old implements, but a lot of steam-powered engines. And you're going to see some old gas-powered. A lot of things such as that are going to be on display. So it's kind of a neat weekend to show the kids how some of the early gas engines and how they would work and be able to do things like threshing and cutting of wood and such. Word of Life is rolling through next. Going through with their little train. Orphan train is a historically accurate thing back in the day when different things were killing adults. Nearly 1900s, things like that happened and happened quite regularly around that 1918 time frame when the flu went through, Spanish flu. Uppsala Area Historical Society rolling on through here with an old truck, and of course the Borgstrom House is open. They've got food over there and some music. Old time music will be going on over there today. Actually, that engine sounds really good for 1928. Next, we've got the school. Some of the teachers and such from the school are rolling on through here, the Uppsala Area Schools. Some of the kids up on the float, and you're seeing staff coming through. A lot of staff over there. And you're seeing some of the staff rolling through right here. Doing their thing here today. You missed your chance at fame right there. You walked right by the cameras. That's right. Great Christian Library, Wanda Erickson right there was in the front of that as they rolled on through, right behind the teachers. Michael's Trucking coming through with one of their big trucks. Coming onto the screens about now. truck you want to have, full of candy. Next, we've got, coming out of the screens, you've got Ripplinger Plumbing out of Holdingford. They are rolling on through here next. takes off. Oh,
get her.
Knights of Columbus coming out of the screen next. And then the party cart from Vernix coming through. Paul and Kathy right there. Looks like they're family and a few friends there, so they are good to go. Stearns Bank coming through next. Freeler Farms trees and such just to the northeast of Uppsala. And of course, we get into the holiday season, they will be doing freshly cut Christmas trees right there. We're about halfway or half an hour into today's parade here in Uppsala. Semi-pro diesel repair and the truck service out of Swanton there. Himself is right there. Almost walked. He went right by and I didn't catch him. Was that Ron? That's Ron.
You do? How are you?
Yes, that was. That's Ron.
How you doing?
So one of those exciting things when you are older and you have glasses set for one at distance. And when people go by, sometimes you just don't see them properly. Watching us live though from Uppsalik, rolling on through here with today's parade. Oh, we were doing so well without music and now we'll have some and that might kill our video. Lawn mowing? Who is it? is an unusual AMX. I don't know if I've ever seen one of those. Centra Soda Express is coming through next. Centra Soda, of course, is where the car show is going to be going on today. Right kind of behind me, if you're familiar from the camera view of where I'm at. So now there's a horse that I think that most of us could ride without too much problem. Centra Soda working their way through. Yeah, that would be a horse ride I think I could handle. Not gonna go crazy, it's not gonna throw me off, it's not gonna demand much for food. Only needs a new paint job every like 5 to 10 years. I think I can handle that. We're coming to you live from Uppsala. Sun's trying to peek through a little bit here today. Delayed today because of the rain. We started at about 11:30 today instead of the 10:30 time frame. So a lot of the activities out at the park are going to be pushed back just a little bit. Such as one of those was after the parade, there's going to be a Wild West shootout today. Albany Area Community Band is rolling through. Ponies coming through next. And there's the little one. Oxen Acres Dairy out of Swanville coming through. On the back of the truck. That guy or gal, that guy's got the best ride today. Right there, the ox bars. There we are, coming on through here. Dressed up in Wild West attire there, or Western. Yeah, that one horse is a little on the small side. Doing a wonderful job. That's a well-trained pup there. There's the Schultz right there. Mike and Jan rolling on through. Mike, who used to to announce the parades as they roll through town here. And he's right there. I think we are just about done with the parade today. We'll let you listen to the old time music one more time as it rolls through. The old time music is going to be headed down to the Borgstrom House here in just a few minutes. Oh, the young ladies have got the numbers for the drawing. 50-50 drawing.
Please join us. We're going to have a little lunch down at the Heritage Borgstrom Park down there. I'd like to invite everyone to come down there, have a little snack, a little entertainment.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is it for today's parade here in Uppsala. As you mentioned, Borgstrom House is going to have some things going on at the park. There's going to be a car show. There's a lot of things going on here today. You can be involved, and it goes all day into the evening with fireworks and entertainment things tonight. And then, yeah, great weekend here, and then there's a community worship service tomorrow. Lots of fun stuff. Go check out this week's edition of the Hometown News. Go to the Facebook page just above. It should be bookmarked or pinned to the top. You guys can check that out, and we will catch you next time. This is John Young with the Hometown News. Thanks for watching.